take a second example. And in our second example, we have 3 over 4 into 3x minus 2 is greater than negative 1 over 4 and less than 1 over 2. So this is how we read this type of questions. So assuming I give you x and then I put negative 3 and positive 5 here. So this can be read as, you don't say negative 3 is greater than x or negative 3 is less than x. No. You mention the variable x first, okay? And x should be in the middle. So we have x is greater than negative 3 and less than 5, okay? So the same way I'm saying 3 over 4 into 3x minus 2 is greater than negative 1 over 4 and less than half. So we are going to solve this inequality, okay? Now, so if we want to solve this inequality, what we are going to do is, normally when you are given a fraction, okay, you look out for your LCM and you multiply through the whole inequality by what? The LCM. So now we are going to treat this as one equation and then this as also the second equation. So we have this, a combination of two equations put in one. So this is the first equation. So without this, this is the first equation. And then without this, this is the second equation. So there are two separate equations put together for you to solve it. And normally, whatever you do over here in the middle, you can do the same. So you have to do the same thing on the left-hand side and then on the right-hand side, okay? So property of equality is very, very important here, okay? So over here, what's our LCM? We have 4, 4, and 2. So definitely, our LCM is 4. So we are going to multiply through the whole inequality by what? 4. So when we multiply here by 4, we shall have 4 times negative 1 over 4. Then we have 4 times 3 over 4 into 3x minus 2. Then less than, we have 4 times 1 over 2. So 4 going to 4, we have negative 1. Then we have 4 going to 4, we have 3 into 3x minus 2. Then we have 2 here, we have 2. So this will give us 2. So now, in our middle term, we have this, which we have to get rid of the brackets. So now we are going to expand in the middle term. Okay, so expanding the middle term, we shall have negative 1 less than 3 times 3 is 9x, and then 3 times negative 2 is negative 6. It's less than, then we have 2. Now, this will give us, from what you can see here, okay, I have this as the left side, this in the middle, and this on the right. Whatever I'm going to do here, I'm going to make sure I do the same thing to the left-hand side and the right-hand side. Now, the main idea here is, we need to make x stand alone in the middle. That is the whole truth. X should be in the middle. So if I have 9x minus 6, what do I do to the minus 6 if I want to get rid of it? I'm going to add positive 6 here, positive 6 here, and positive 6 here. So this is going to be positive 6 minus 1. Then I have 9x minus 6 plus 6. And then I have 2 plus 6. So I'm adding 6 to both sides. So I have minus 1 plus 6. 9x minus 6 plus 6, and then 2 plus 6. So 6 minus 1 will give me 5. Then this will give me 0. So I have 9x, and then I have 8. So if I want to solve for x, I'm going to divide both sides by what? 9. So I divide here by 9, here by 9, and here by 9. My solution becomes x here, we shall have 5 over 9, and then 8 over 9. So this becomes our solution for this. And we can read this as x is greater than 5 over 9 and less than 8 over 9.